same as 12. He said, Moses, he said, Aaron, for you driving the bed away from the feast, your children will go and suffer in a foreign land for 430 years. That is the one the Lord knows about, not our own. He said, at my own time, I will go to Egypt and return them. Is that not the promise? That's the promise. Hmm. And when you look at the book of Exodus, Exodus 10, from verse 20 to the end, Exodus 11, from verse 6 to 11, Exodus 12, from verse 1 to 10. He said, this is the night you are living. Mm. He said, eat everything while standing. Have your staff in your hand. And if a family is too small for an animal, let a family share. You are living today. But to assure you, to affirm the security, put blood at the lintel of what? Of your house.
Okay.
And if the angel is coming past you through, he will spear you.
Mm.
But any of the Egyptians who fail to listen, to hearken to this, is doomed.
Jesus Christ.
Mm.
Then when you look at the book of Exodus 12, from verse 12 to 21, he said that night was a painful night.
Mm.
Every home was lamenting and crying. Even the ant of the what? The ant that go on the floor. And the animal, the goat in the kitchen, lost their first son.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, sir.
So when you look at it, this is quite different from the one of the Nigerians. Hardship, recession, poverty, laziness pushed Nigeria out of this land. Let me tell you.
Okay, sir.
When you look at the book of Genesis 26, 1 to 10, he said, Isaac, please I beg you in the name of God, don't go into slavery again as your father did. And when you look at the book of Isaiah 30, Exodus 38, Exodus 39, he wasn't even telling us all these things. In Isaiah 38, Isaiah 39, then Isaiah 40, Isaiah 41, then Isaiah 47, then Isaiah 49, then Isaiah 38, then Isaiah 39. In Isaiah 38, he said, if you said I'm going to die, I'd rather die in my country here. But wash me, examine me, peruse me, go over me, see how I worship you. Then when you look at where the cause of Nigeria started, is in the book of Deuteronomy 31, verse 26, 27, 28. He said, I am still here with you. You cannot use your hand to walk. Before they start bringing them back, do you know since 2001, the Igbo people have been selling their kidney in Malaysia?
No, I'm not very aware.
Oh my God. The Igbo people have been selling their kidney.
Kidney business?
Yes, for $2,000. Even the latest one in what? In Egypt. In India, they have been selling their kidney for $1,000. Then when you look at it again, the Igbo people have been using blankets to kill their in-law since 2001 to bring spare parts to Nigeria. It's hardship. Huh. How many Igbo are in the power except during the time of Goodluck regime? Hausa never trust Igbo unless they want to use them for dirty job. Hausa never trust Yoruba because they wanted to, unless they wanted to make them to write speech. You know Chukwuma Ereke was the one writing speech for Babangida? That was why Babangida made him what? A minister. And that was the arrogancy that was in the head of his son to tomorrow.
Taekwondo expert?
Yes. Nothing like Taekwondo. What can we make from Taekwondo?
No, it's Taekwondo expert.
The father is out of sense.
Okay, sir.
The son too will be out of sense.
Okay, sorry.
Ezekiel 16:44.
Okay,
sir. He said, like father, like son. No woman live with Chukwuma Ereke. Chukwuma Ereke was a harlot keeper. During his time, his own time. So automatically with the question you are asking, nobody send anybody to Libya. Nobody send anybody to Germany. Nobody ever take permission from any ministry, either external affair or internal affair, that they are going to where? South Africa now. We never send them. We never send them. What they are doing there was too bad. Nigerians are busy selling drugs in Kenya. Nigerians are busy selling cocaine in what?
South Africa.
Nigerians are doing bad things in what? In Canada. Nigerians are doing horrible things in Ghana, in London. So why would they not be sent back home?
Sure.
But we did that before. When there was hardship in Ghana, we are the one that asked the Ghanaian to leave.
Yes.
And then
Ghana must go.
That's the one you are using to carry your wife's clothes, your children back nowadays. Anybody wanted to travel for Christmas now must buy 3 Ghana must go. Even if anybody wanted to travel abroad, they use Ghana must go to make it lighter, not to carry more weight. That is it. You know what I'm saying, sir?
Yes, sir.
So even though if they die there, they should ask themselves who sent them there.
But Nigeria is hot. There's no problem.
What is hot in Nigeria? Let me tell you.
You said there's no job.
In one plot of land, my reporter. One plot of land.
Yes, sir.
In Abaranje. In Abeokuta Expressway here, on the way to Badagry. If you build your 3-bedroom flat, don't bother to furnish it. At the end of the other corner of the house, put your snail there. Just 100 snail. All the leftover eba, all the leftover pawpaw, all the leftover rams, all the leftover anything. Just pour it there as waste. Go back there after 4 years. You will see more than 4,000 snails.
For 4 years?
Yes. Then again, go and buy 3 family of grass cutter. 3 family of what? Of grass cutter. On your 2 plot of land. Just use granite. Make those anti-hills and put your grass cutter. You know one grass cutter? A family is a father and mother with 3
children.
So if one should have 10 children after 1.5 years, that means that 4 females providing you another 40 females. Where are you going to be in another 6 years in that business? It's laziness. 1 Thessalonians 3. And if you are sleeping there, you still have the right to have artisan dog. Anything you cannot guide during the night, your dog will help you. The puppy of the dog too will be sold. But Nigerians are lazy. The other name of Buhari is laziness. The other name of Atiku is laziness. The other name of Fashola is idleness. They want to use brain. Fashola is so brilliant. Atiku is so brilliant. The man who founded GTB is so brilliant. He's stealing people's money. Look at the bank now. What happened in Canada 10 years ago? When the Canadians are fighting the Indian people, the Indians said this bullshit to what? To the Canadian. You gave us Canadian what? Canadian citizenship. We are here. You said all our lives we are going to sign it with contractor. No. We will not get gratuity. We better go back to our country.
Huh.
But Nigerians are still staying there, taking the rubbish money. Taking what? The rubbish money.
Rubbish money.
Then, it has happened in our banks now. When you get to First Bank, when you meet 80 people, 60 are contract staff of 40,000
minimum.
Peg what? Peg salary. Then when you move from there again, go to NNPC, all contracts. Who started this before? It's UBA. When the naughty man who sold UBA to the Igbo man, Enubelu.
That is Osage.
Yeah. His brother started it.
Kimbelu.
Kimbelu, his brother started it. The contract staff.
I know, that's Demola Adekogbe.
To create money to Adekogbe.
It's Adekogbe. It's late now. He just went to heaven.
But what ended Adekogbe?
He went to heaven suddenly, sir. He just went to heaven suddenly, sir. Yes.
So what about monuments? What Baba Blue?
This,
look at the other man in Ogun State now.
That's he won. Okay, Kasinti?
No, Kasinti. The other one with Loto.
Adebutu.
Adebutu.
Kesinti.
He said he wants his son to be governor.
Yes, they are on it now, sir.
So automatically, he cannot be.
No, he wants to become the governor, sir.
I said he cannot be.
They have been dashing their matching and
he cannot cars. Be. Even he can dash girlfriend to people who did not have
100,000, 50,000.
They can dash girlfriend to people that lost their wife. Okay. Put sugar into your mouth. If you eat, if you add 200 bags of sugar, you will see and sleep in the night with bitterness. Please, my brother, don't bother about all this. So, going to abroad, going to everything, the youth did not want to work. I just go and meet them in Ogun State. Go to Ogun State. Virtually the worst state in the whole world is Ogun State.
How all do you mean, sir?
All their youth is into Yahoo Yahoo. They go, they join Ogoni. They join all sorts of courts because of Yahoo Yahoo. Oyibo man's money. Oyibo God. What will be the end of all those youths? They will run mad. They will kill their mother. They will kill their wife. They will stab. Look at them, some of their son from Oyo State. From Ife and all those ones, they were betting on drugs. The musician, the senator dancer.
No, it's a similar gentleman, Adeleke.
Adeleke is a family.
Anyway, Davido.
Davido. Yes, they were betting on drugs. He didn't kill his friend. He finished the round of the 20 something, but he cannot pick the money. He picked them. So, that is it. These are the type of youth we have. Do we have youth in the country? No. And when you see this December, a star will be doing promo. They will bring Kano from, they will bring Thierry Henry from England to come and help them drink one bottle of stout in Nigeria. So they will be dancing like a monkey is singing or a banana. All Nigerian youth are being taught how to drink. What will happen to their kidney and liver? What will happen to their kidney and liver by 2030? And then the impotent will be high on the land. Blindness will be high on the land. Go to the Coca-Cola. Sugar everywhere.
Diabetes patients.
If they come back, the only thing when you do not ask.
Yes, sir.
Buhari lo jere. Bela amoton ko wala ti lo yinbo yi.
How does Buhari benefit, sir?
Bo pa amoton ko wala ti oni baba iti doma Buhari. It's Buhari and Oshibajo's son.
You mean the pregnancy
even
that
the shepherd, our shepherd, Mr. Adeniran, most superior evangelist Adeniran, said, yes, Akima Sobeo, all the whole Omo Hedi Moruko wala ti Libya, Oruko Oni Mojiri.
Jesus.
Nigeria Shekini, Nigeria Jiri. Hey, yo, kolo lo meri, lo pada. Nigeria Jiri. My brother, I'm going to Ejaje. Nigeria Shekini, Nigeria Jiri. Amo, you know, I'm going to hotel, to buy ya. Toma to shishe hotel, toma she pornography, toma she everything. O mo jota mo ibo tin ba ye awon Yoruba je leko. Ton tin show pornography
films.
To ba gbo won tin go the commissioner of police in Lagos State. Now they have 99 cases of what? Of pedophile.
Edgar.
Young 97 years old man, 68 years old man. Making love to 8 years baby.
Jesus.
9 years baby daughter. Jesus. And 6 years daughter this morning.
Jesus Christ.
It's because of what? Because of the
blue film.
Those films. And when you see all the Igbo shops in Lagos, the Igbo has been selling this. I've warned Tinubu. Ever before Tinubu, I've been warning that they should raid all those shops so that all these boys and girls should have time to what? To read. And all the telephone they have in their hands, they subscribe to it and watch it when their mother is asleep. And these are the babies and daughters you raise in a single room. You know, I told you the issue of Roman Ipalo in some place.
Yes, yes, sir, yes, sir.
The man who went to Second World War.
Yes, sir.
So when he came back from the war, everybody in the village welcomed the man.
He survived the war?
For surviving the war.
Okay.
And the man has 5 children.
Okay.
And they were living in a single room.
Okay, with their mother.
With their mother. So when it was in the night, the woman who has even not even crossed the husband, the man not made love to her for the past 2 years of the war. So when it was around 9 o'clock after the good food, she gave to the husband. So when they were about to romance themselves on the bed, Chinedu, the smallest baby, just went there to put the father. Said, if you fight civil war, world war, why are you fighting mommy now?
What, so, was he not sleeping, sir?
No, both of them are half naked.
Okay, no, so they don't have sleep.
No, they are not sleeping. You know, they've been playing a long night before.
Okay, sir.
But their parents want them to sleep before it.
Okay, sir.
So he pulled the father down. So the father said, no, we are not fighting. I have only play with your mother. So he said, daddy, no, don't do that to me again. So they all slept. So when it was exactly 10:30, when he said, maybe all the children have slept, the father stood up and used his hand to do their nose and everything and see
if they slept.
Before West slept. So now, if I, when the man just wanted to climb the wife again, he said, daddy, we warn you. We warn you. That mommy alone, don't kill mommy. You told us how many people you killed in the war front. So when it was exactly 1 o'clock, the woman cannot tolerate this thing again. So he said, Baba Wurujapo, what we are going to do, all my judge, then he now tie all their judge together.
The rapper?
Yes. So they now use their marine rope, the one they are using to fetch well, fetch water in the well. Yes, so they nail it to the wall. They divide the room into two. So they nail it and pull the clothes. And that was the first room and parlor in Warri.
So that was the story of
Rumah. That's how the man freed himself from this menace of this useless boat. Because they used something to cover their bedside and put the three settee to cover it. So the bed is at the back of the settee. The issue of the three bedroom flat.
That's quite interesting.
So because those boys are watching over their mother.
Yeah.
So that they never know the game. The game that brought them to life was the game they wanted to play. But those guys are instrumental. They are very destructive. They want to spoil that night.
You want to drain it.
So, but that man said, we will satisfy you. That was what happened, you know. Obey's case set.
Yes, sir.
Only man tell you, Lord, when you're home. And when my baba walk, it's the only one to receive commander. One pick a judge, you know. One fish a cotton. Oh, you're in a cotton. You don't want one. Anytime this cotton is down, nobody pass here. You know, I went to war. If I shoot you, just shoot the gun off. Don't ever see you pass this place. I shoot your leg. And whenever all their friends come to the house, say, not go there, not go there. Daddy said you go there, they shoot your leg. So at times in the afternoon they made love. And that's the issue of
Rumah Parlour.
The first room and the parlour is worried.